The Passover holiday is the most important holiday for the Jewish people. It is the holiday in where the Jewish people began. We started as a nation, the children of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Abraham was our forefather, the first Jewish father who recognized monotheism in the world, one God. His descendants, Isaac, then Jacob, who then went down into Egypt, were enslaved by Pharaoh, the king of Egypt, for 210 years. After 210 years, God saw the suffering and the torture in which the children of Israel experienced, and then took them out of Egypt on this holiday called Passover, released them from Egypt, brought freedom, led them into the desert, and brought them to the most important event for the Jewish people called the giving of the Torah at Sinai. And at the giving of the Torah, God gave the Ten Commandments, which then went into 613 commandments, and a commitment for the Jewish nation to adhere to the commandments of the Torah and to pass them on from one generation to the next. So when it comes to Passover, we celebrate that time where we were no longer just a people, children of those that recognized one God, but we became God's nation, and we became God's chosen nation. God chose the nation to give the Torah at Sinai for these people to adhere to its commandments and forever have this special relationship with God known as the children of Israel or the Jewish people. So we take this holiday and we eat the only type of Jewish food that we're really commanded to eat during the year, which is called matzah. The matzah symbolizes the flat bread in which it did not have time to rise when running and rushing out of Egypt, and it remained flat. And we eat this cracker, this matzah, for 8 days to remember the holiday of Passover. But most of all, we celebrate with what's called two seders. Seder means an order, and it's 15-step dinner with a service with special types of food to remember the slavery, and we drink 4 cups of wine to remember the 4 expressions in which God promised the Jewish people, I will take you out of Egypt. And we eat this matzah. And the main mitzvah, the main commandment of the Seder is to pass on the story to our children. And one of the most important messages in the Haggadah, in the prayer book in which we use tonight and tomorrow night, is a verse that says that in every single generation, nations of the world stood up to annihilate this chosen children, the Jewish people. But the Almighty God saved us from their hands. And if we look at history, we have been through many wars, not just the state of Israel, but throughout history. Many, many wars in which Jewish people were persecuted everywhere in the world, in every country in the world. Whether it's in the Middle East, whether it was in Europe, whether it was in expulsion from Spain, from Britain, where I was born and raised. And here we are. So I asked the question, have we ever lost a war? And the answer is no. We have never lost a war because we are still here, such a small minority of people. So I want to get off the serious tone and I want to encourage my dear brothers and sisters, the Jewish people, and all friends of the Jewish people. In every generation, they stand up to annihilate us. And today, they're in masks outside Columbia University. And they're calling for the death of Jews and the death of a country of kindness called the United States of America, a country that has been blessed. If we go back to the Bible, God says, those that are good to my children, I will protect and have them prosper. He told it to Abraham, our forefather. Well, that's what United States of America represents. And today, they are calling for death of Israel once again, and death now of the United States of America. I must reach out, say to my fellow Jews and fellow Americans, that we must not fear. We must not be worried. We have never lost a war, and we will never lose a war because the Almighty God saves us from their hands. Be strong. Celebrate Passover. It is so important, more than anything now, to remember that there are those in captivity. There are those that are hostages being viciously taken away. These are not innocent victims that have been hurt in times of war. These are victims that were targeted and killed just for the sake of being Jewish, no different to being taken to the concentration camps in Nazi Europe. And tonight we're going to have a special remembrance through prayer of the over 100 living hostages, or whatever it is, the hostages alive or not alive. And we're going to remember them, and we're going to pray to the Almighty God and say, Hashem, release them, free them, just as you did back in the days of Egypt. Jewish law tells us that a body comes from the ground and it has to be returned respectively to the ground. We have an obligation to seek those that have not yet been given the respected farewell that they are supposed to give. So absolutely, it's very important to bring back those that have lost their life. But we're also hoping and putting our emphasis on those specifically that are still alive, that the Almighty God should free them from the hands of this wicked enemy called Hamas, and anyone that believe, and those that believe in their philosophy as well. Those that believe and stand and chant for Hamas are just as evil. They support terrorism, and we ask that the Almighty God should protect us from all of these people, whether they're there in Israel, in Gaza, or if they're on the streets of New York City. The Almighty God will save us from their hands, and we're not afraid.
How can people in the community give or pray or think about and keep the people here, the Jewish community here, and then of course abroad in Israel, in their hearts and minds?
You answered your own question. How could Jewish people or anyone, any civilized person, give or pray or do something good? The answer is to give charity, support the Israeli Defense Forces, support the people in Israel that are suffering mad amount of mental health issues that hundreds and hundreds of families are suffering. We never chose this war. We never went to war. So that's how we can respond and we can give. How we could pray, everyone knows how to pray. Stop, close your eyes, say Almighty God. But most of all, accompany it with a mitzvah, with a good deed. Do an act of kindness, be good to your neighbors, teach your children the difference between right and wrong. Tell your children no, by you standing up and thinking that you found a noble cause in a wicked enemy is wrong. Be careful what you're reading, the propaganda on the TikToks and the Instagrams and all the garbage and that is going around, because that's all it really is. It's propaganda, and it's scary propaganda, because this is how Nazi Germany began. It didn't start one day that they drove everyone. So let us be strong together. Let us celebrate whilst there is something missing in our hearts. We are nevertheless going to celebrate with joy. We are going to celebrate with full koyach, with full strength. We are going to say, thank you, God. We are going to say, we remember. We are going to say, we're never going to forget. And most of all, we're going to say, we, the Jewish people, will live on. Am Yisrael Chai, next year in Jerusalem, L'shana Haba'ah B'Yerushalayim.
Hi, I'm Rochelle Murcia with Eyewitness News, Bakersfield Now on YouTube. Thank you for checking out our YouTube channel, where we have tons of great content to choose from. While you're here, go ahead and click on the subscribe button right there. That way you can stay up to date on all the things related within Kern County. Thanks for watching.